exemplary zeal and his performance leaves a lot of people asking and craving for more. Filmfare as a magazine has tried to tap into the vibe of the country, tried to straddle regional and Bollywood movies, and he's probably one of our really successful crossover artists in terms of kind of movies he's done. I know at least five people who are dying to sign him on in Bollywood, and he's extremely choosy about his films, so we'll come to that a little later. But thank you so much for taking time off your busy schedule and coming. And thank you, I know it's been a tough time for all of us. Thank you for being here, and thank you for encouraging Filmfare the way you have for the last 6 to 2 years. Thank you so much.
முன்னாடியே வந்து நம்ம கமிட் பண்ணி முன்னாடியே இது பண்ண ஒரு விஷயம். ஸோ அதனால இது இந்த கேங்கில் பண்ணியா அதனால தான் இங்கே இருக்கும். அப்படி ஒரு பெருமை, மிகப்பெரிய பெருமை கௌரவம் ஃபிலிம்ஃபேருங்கிறது ஒரு கலாச்சாரம். ஸோ எனக்கு ஆறு வருடத்தில் ஃபிலிம்ஃபேர் வாங்கியிருக்கேன் அப்படிங்கிறது ஒரு மிகப்பெரிய பெருமை. இந்த ஒரு சின்ன வயசுலேருந்தே ஒரு ஃபிலிம்ஃபேர் அப்படிங்கிற நம்ம அண்ணாந்து பார்த்த ஒரு விஷயம், நடிகானதுக்கப்புறம் கூட ஃபிலிம்ஃபேர் இருந்து அப்படிங்கிறது அண்ணாந்து பார்த்த ஒரு விஷயம் மாதிரி ஒரு கிட்டத்தட்ட ஒரு 9 வருடம் 10 வருடம் கிடையாது. அதுக்கப்புறம் தான் நிறைய ஃபிலிம்ஃபேர் நான் பார்த்தேன். ஸோ அப்படி ஒரு அந்த மாதிரி நம்ம அண்ணாந்து பார்த்த ஒரு விஷயம் இன்றைக்கி என்னோட கவர் லான்ச்க்கு இருக்கும் அப்படிங்கிறது ரொம்ப பெருமையாகவும் சந்தோஷமாகவும் இருக்குது. எல்லாருடைய சப்போர்ட்டுக்கும் நன்றி. தேங்க்யூ ஸோ மச். I don't want to see them, I don't want to go there, and I shied away from them, and I don't know, I was forced into acting, and then after a few years I realized this is my thing, I mean this is what I'm supposed to do, and I realized I wouldn't have done anything better than this. And for some people, you know, they identify their calling, for some people their calling identifies them, and such lucky one.
When was that one moment you realized that this is my calling?
I cannot identify that one moment. It was a slow, gradual process of understanding. For me, it happened around 2004 to 2006. That 2 years slowly, I understood what else would I be doing.
So, what's changed from say that song "Man Magar Asa" to "Mali" or the VIP that you just did, which was so hugely successful? What has changed from then and now?
Much older, it's a different
thing. You don't look it.
I find myself mature, and I find myself more choosy, and I've learned to say no. And other than that, it's pretty much the same.
And one last question, which I'm always curious to know. How do you handle the pressures of starting when you wake up on a day, how do you cope with pressures? Like when I said schizophrenic existence, you're doing some separate things at the same time. How do you manage that?
For me, shooting or having my family or anything else is absolutely fine. But you know, you're constantly being watched, and you keep one step wrong, and you know, people just trash you. And like,
that's
really scary. I mean, it's not even if it's not intentional, even if you're unaware of it and you've done something randomly, and everybody picks up it, and with social media and everything now, it has become scarier. So,
how has social media changed, say, life in terms of, say, box office? does social media help actors' box office?
Definitely it helps. It's made, marketing has become a little easier with social media, and if you know how to use it correctly, then it's really helpful with the openings and everything. But social media is a very tricky place, and you know, it's the same place where they throw mud at your face and shower rose water on your head. So, you just have to take it to be like the rose water always cleans the mud. From the beginning itself, I wanted to have a balance. I wanted to mix it up. I wanted to do both kind of films. And my brother is strictly against me doing commercial films. He wants me to do classy film, and he was the one who taught me everything about acting. And he groomed me, he made me a star. So he was even in the beginning when I was doing commercial films, he was completely against it. But I wanted to do that also. I wanted to do everything. Suddenly I want to do a comedy, then I want to do a rom-com, then a complete action flick, then a family drama. I want to do everything. So I chose my scripts based on, on my previous release. For example, now Mari is a complete commercial flick, the next one will be complete family drama. So I choose my next one based on my previous release. But it's something that I have to do, because otherwise I would get stuck in an image that I can do only these kind of films, and that's a horrible place. I don't want to be there.
You don't want to get caught in an image trap?
No, I don't want to.
Okay. One other question. I think with the exception of one Tamil film, Pallavan, I think, wherein you showcased your physical prowess, exposing your biceps and all. While contrastingly, while all other actors want to show off, you know, they want to have that biceps and that six-pack stuff and all. You seem to be quite different. It's not the same look. Why so? Was it intentional? Is it intentional?
If it helps the script, otherwise I don't